Hey guys, this is Jessen from Edulogix, where we teach you logic behind things. Welcome back to my channel, and in my today's video, I'll be telling you everything that you must know on how to meet your English language requirement for your Australian nursing registration. Let's get started. The Nursing and Midwifery Board of Australia's English Language Standard is an important standard for all overseas registered nurses to meet. And there are two ways to meet this standard. The first way is by proving that English is your primary language and you have done your tertiary nursing qualification or at least 6 years of your primary and secondary education in English from a recognized country. Now, the recognized countries list is provided on APRA's website, and it typically includes countries like Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, UK, USA, Canada, and Ireland. To meet this standard, you'll have to, of course, submit all your proofs from your schools and colleges that you have attended, mentioning clearly that your qualification was completely delivered as well as assessed only in English. If this is not the case for you, don't get disheartened. You can prove your English proficiency via the second method, which is English language testing pathway. The English language testing pathway is nothing but you can take one of the four tests approved by APRA and meet the requirement by achieving the desired score as published by APRA. So many overseas registered nurses ask me, when do they have to submit the English language testing results? Is it at the beginning of the OBA procedure or at the time you're going to write the NCLEX examination, or is it at the end? So stay till the end of the video and I'll be answering this common question for you. So coming back to the English language tests that you can take, which are approved by APRA, there are four tests that you can take. You can take an IELTS Academic, a PT Academic, an OET or a TOEFL IBT. So these are the test scores that you need to achieve if you take this pathway. And I will leave the link of the English language standard in the description box below where you can read more about it. Also, an important point, if you're not able to get these desired test scores in one single attempt, there is a provision for you to club your scores as long as your sittings are within a period of 6 months. If you're taking PT Academic, you need to achieve 65 overall score and your individual scores in each of the domains, that is listening, reading, speaking and writing, should also be 65. If in case you are not able to achieve this score in one single sitting, you are allowed to club your scores within the two sittings, provided you have taken the two exams within a period of 6 months. Your overall score in both sittings should be 65 and your individual score in any of the communicative skills, that is listening, reading, writing or speaking, should not be less than 58 in any of these sittings. Remember, these scores are valid for only 2 years. So whenever you submit these documents to APRA, make sure the validity is correct. Now coming to the big question, when should you write this examination and does the APRA require these results at the beginning of your procedure or at the mid or at the end? So the answer is, you do not need to worry about getting these desired scores at the start of your procedure. You have to submit these documents or prove your English proficiency only after you have passed the OSCE examination and when you apply to APRA for your registration. Hence, we advise all the nurses to not worry about it right now and start your OBA procedure immediately and start preparing for your NCLEX exam. Between your NCLEX and OSCE, you'll have a good amount of time to start your English language preparation as well. Hope you found this video useful. If you like this video, please ensure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so that you are notified whenever I put a new video. Also, make sure to check out my website for all the interesting blogs, posts and informative videos as well as courses that will help you in your nursing career. Until next time, stay safe and stay happy.